Don't tell my wife, but I've got a secret.
From Hollywood, the show that reveals all, I've got a secret. And now let's meet the star of I've Got a Secret, Steve Allen.
You? Oh, he's amazing. Hi. Good evening and welcome to the new I've Got a Secret. How long can I go on saying it's new? I mean, at some point, it's got to be ridiculous, right? Anyway, tonight's panelists are a very impressive group. One of our favorites, comedian Pat Carroll, actor, comedian, whatever, farceur. I think that's one of the things you are, Artie Johnson. The lovely Broadway and TV performer. I saw her performing on lovely Broadway about a week ago. And it is Gillette. And our anchorman, the immensely amusing Richard Anchorman Dawson. That's the panel for us.
Yes.
Could I be angry?
And now we're going to open the Great Wall, and I have every confidence that we will find a contestant of some kind. Yes, there he is, a guest.
Hello?
Hello.
Would
you tell our panel your name, sir?
Jim Killingbeck.
Jim Killingbeck, panel. And where are you from, Jim?
Seattle, Washington.
Seattle, and your age?
17.
Very mature, 17, wouldn't you say? Yeah. Well, panelists, this young man's secret concerns an invention of his that he's going to demonstrate for you momentarily. But to make sure there's no danger, we're going to lower the safety net here, which we will be able to do in, oh, yeah, there it comes, by golly, the old safety net. Back in place again. You notice which side I'm on and which side he's on, right? Panel, at this point, I must ask you to put on your blindfolds, and you must do it, too, which is more important.
If you lower that net over us, I'm going to be very disappointed in you.
So, Jim, if you'll whisper your secret to me through the net, I guess it'll have to be, we'll let the audience know what your invention is.
That's what we want.
As I say, panel, it's something that young Mr. Killingbeck has invented and is prepared now to demonstrate for the audience, if not for you, visually. We'll start the questioning with Pat Carroll.
Jim, is this something that flies? Oh, golly, yes, I guess it does.
Well, you just lost me.
Woo-wee!
What comes after hallowed be thy name? Oh, don't ever do that, Jim.
No, that's unfair.
Well, that sound, whatever it was, it sounded rocketry to me. Is your invention, and I did say something flying, does it have to do with some form of rocketry?
Yes, it does.
Very good start, Pat. You may take off your you may take off your panel, I started to say. Take off your mask.
Now, this is the last time I'm going to warn you, Jim.
Oh, this is silly. I'm the nearest one to whatever it is. How do we know he's not an arsonist gone mad?
Okay, Artie, it's up to you to do whatever you can.
Does your mother know you do this, Jim?
Yes, she does.
Does she approve of this thing you do? Or this thing you invented? Obviously,
yes, she does.
Wow.
Something's happening and I...
A young man just grabbed one off in the audience.
Yeah? You ought to sit with the panel for a while.
In a manner of speaking. What's that?
Nothing, I won't. All
right.
Good taste, I don't want to get a trophy. Boy, am I glad that thing went off.
Yes, well, you may now take your blindfold off, Artie. And we'll move along, see what's happening.
If I...
Holy smoke. There it goes.
You don't listen, do you, Jim? I mean, you just don't listen.
Thank you, Richard. Anita, what do you have in mind in the way of a question or two?
If I pass, will he stop?
Anita, I trust me. There's nothing that can harm you.
Oh, all right.
That's all right. They don't bite too much.
It what? does it have to do with the launcher? Your invention? Is it something that you invented to launch it?
Yes, it does launch up.
But is it the thing you invented? Is it the launcher or is it the whole rocket and the launcher? It's the both.
Is it the launcher
or the
launchee?
Yes. Is the launcher? Can I ask a question?
Take the thing off.
Anita, you may now take your blindfold off, and you'll see what's happening. Richard Dawson, unfortunately, has passed away.
You can torture me. I'll reveal nothing.
Just a name ranking sort.
Were you anything to do with the Blitz in London, Jim?
No, he wasn't around then.
Oh. Aha!
I have it, a large snake.
Jim, Dick, Jim.
Yes.
With the exception of yourself, has there been any insanity in your family?
I don't think so.
Is this a buzzer I hear, or is this long lost love?
Let's see, I think it's going to happen again. You may take your mask off, Richard, and let's see, I think... Yeah, oh, there goes another one.
The old electronic frisbee.
Yeah.
Gag, eh?
That one was... Ladies and gentlemen, we've just learned that one went all the way over to Channel 4. Pretty weird. Anyway, now that you see what's going on here, panel, officially, Mr. Killingbeck's secret is that he was launching his invention, a rocket-powered frisbee. Isn't that nice? You may remember... You may remember reading about this invention in the book titled Who Needs It? You possibly saw that. He's going to do a grand finale.
Oh, and
we're not, no, we're going to put this down again.
You're going in there, right?
No, I'm just for a moment to sign his last will and testament. Are these regular frisbees you attach the things to?
Right, I attach the two rocket engines to it, one at the side to spin it around and one at the bottom to push it up into the air.
Good.
That is your basic two-rocket frisbee, right?
Standard two-rocket frisbee.
Right.
His and hers. And, well, we're going to lower the net again. Yeah. Get out of here now.
Great conversation back there. You weren't frightened, were you, Steve?
Now,
this is the first time he has worked with a net.
It's going to be a group launch at this time.
Oh,
whenever you're ready, Killingbeck, fire away.
Okay.
Stand by. It's a group launch now. Hey! There's... Did one get triggered?
Give me your poor and huddled mask.
Get out of here.
How long will contact with Martin?
Oh, thank you. We'll be right back. Panel, you were very courageous under fire.
Thank you. Have a mushroom.
I've got a secret. We'll blast off again in just 1 minute.
More to give, great to get.
We're a little bit late. We're hurrying along now. Meet our next contestants. Here they come.
Hello. How do you do, sir?
Make yourselves comfortable, folks, and tell us your names, if you would, please.
Mr. and Mrs. Decker.
Mr. and Mrs. Decker, and you are from?
Salem, Oregon.
Panel, the Decker's secret concerns something surprising that happened to them both at the same time. And Mr. and Mrs. Decker, if you'll whisper to me what it was that happened, we'll tell the audience what it was. As I say, panel, it's something that happened to the Deckers at the same time. We'll start the questioning with Richard.
It's nice to have both of you here this evening. You're known as double-deckers, of course, in England, but... We'll move along hurriedly and say all fess, please. Now, could this particular thing that happened to you, Mr. Decker, happen to any of us?
Yes.
Did it happen in your home?
No.
Because I haven't been there for weeks. did it happen in this country?
Yes.
Were you on vacation when it happened?
Right.
Were you in a national park of any kind?
Nope.
Were you in... I'll withdraw the question.
We'll withdraw the buzzer then, if that's the way you feel about it. Thank you, Richard. Pat.
Mr. and Mrs. Decker, or I'll ask Mr. Decker, how long have you and Mrs. Decker been married?
42 years.
That wouldn't help you, however.
Oh, doggone it.
Nice.
Because I thought the secret was you'd met at a swinging singles club or something. thing that you did together, was it something that needed prowess from both of you, or agility?
No.
Not from them. A little of it wouldn't have hurt at the time, but...
Did it have to do with something that occurred to you from some form of transportation?
No.
Not that, no. Two down. Thank you, Pat. Artie.
And now you say this happened as part of your vacation. It happened during a vacation, is that right, Mrs. Decker?
Yes.
It happened in the, was this something that that physically, that did any physical, was it physical in any sense to you?
Oh, somewhat.
In a sense, yes.
Somewhat. Oh, now you should talk to Mr. Decker for a while. No, I won't, because it's a family show. Are there children involved in this particular feat? No, no, just the two of you. Just Mr. and Mrs. Decker. What can two people do these days?
All we've established is that there are no children.
I see.
Anita?
When this, Mr. Decker, when this thing happened to you, were you out of doors?
Yes.
Did it involve an animal of some sort?
No. That's a matter of opinion.
It didn't involve an animal.
No, no. Just a little joke.
But was there another object involved?
Yes.
Did something scare you?
No.
Just so that you're not misled, a momentary fright might have been involved. The Decker secret, you probably read about it, didn't know their names. Spiro Agnew hit them both at the same time with a golf ball. Actually, it's not nice to joke about this because Spiro, the most of the time, he plays golf like an expert, a karate expert. But I understand that you two were in the 71 Bob Hope Desert Classic, is that right, when the thing happened? And we have a little bit of videotape or film, I'm not sure which it is, of the incident, which we're going to see now. And you can tell us just what happened when the vice president let go, as he's about to do here.
Taking his swing.
And right away he winces, he knows he's in trouble. We've all done that sort of thing.
The ball skewed off sharply to the right, hit me on the arm, rolled down on my wife's lap.
My goodness. And did he realize right away who would have happened, that he'd hit you, that sort of thing?
Oh, he knew he had to hit somebody.
What did he say to you, Mrs. Decker, when he came over here?
Well, he was terribly sorry, and he kissed my arm.
Yeah, he was probably aiming at something else. But anyway, he did a very nice thing. As I said, he apologized, and he presented you with some kind of a little get-well present, as it were, didn't
your
he?
Draft notice.
What was the gesture he made?
Well, he passed on a trip that he'd won at Atlanta as the world's worst golf shot. It involved a week's trip to the Miami golf tournament, all expenses paid.
Very nice gesture indeed.
Right.
Thank you very much for joining us. We'll be right back.
We'll be back with our guest star, Bob Barker, right after these messages.
An all-new episode of Lingo, tonight at 9 Eastern and Pacific, only on GSN.
And now let's meet the host of the new Price is Right, the new Bob Barker, ladies and gentlemen. Here he is.
Welcome to I've Got a Secret, Bob.
It's a pleasure to be here. There's a stagehand back here with a frisbee sticking out of his head. Did you know that?
Yes, anyway, I can understand why. We wish, by the way, to congratulate you on the ratings your new show is getting.
Oh, thank you. All of us are most grateful for the response to the show. It's been fantastic. We really are.
Well, now, panel, we're going to play the new Price is Right game, so to speak, with Bob in just a moment. And it's time for me, therefore, to confess to you four that our staff raided your separate homes and apartments and came back with some special items that we will have the audience bid for.
Not one of my children.
Oh. Well, you didn't get anything for my wife,
please,
did you?
One of my children.
Oh, Gisela would give you an invasion map of Poland.
And remember now, they are really things of yours, and the audience, if their bidding is successful, will really take them away. You won't own them anymore. We have decided that. That's the breaks of show business, kid.
As a matter of fact, some of the things they're bidding on, we want them to take away.
Wouldn't be a bad idea. So your job at the moment, panelist, is to guess what item it is that Bob and the group are working on here. I guess that's clear enough. We all set to go, Bob?
Ready to go. You will record the bids, will you, Steve?
I'll man the blackboard. And
all right. Now, we have four contestants up there, do we, Johnny?
Right.
Would you stand them up there, and we'll get down to business. Now, contestants, make your bids in dollars, if you will, please. And the one of you who bids nearest to the retail price of this item without going over wins the item. Now, let me show you what you're bidding on first. I'll do this back here so that the panel can't see. Now, this is what you're bidding on first. And here's the real thing right here. This is the real thing. Very good. Now, in dollars, let's have your first bid.
This is Ellen Pratt.
All right, Ellen, what's your bid?
$5.
All right, she's bid $5. Artie, this is something of yours.
Some kind of sports equipment?
Well...
In his case, I think it is.
As a matter of fact, it may be. I don't know.
But generally, no.
But generally not. No,
next
generally
bid,
not.
Marlene Sharbaugh.
Marlene, what would you bid?
$7.
$7. All right, now, Artie, you may ask me another question about it.
Huh. Oh, might be sports equipment.
Well, now, that's...
No, it's not.
No, no. Normally, this would not.
Is it a piece of... Is it some kind of clothing?
Yes, yes. Clothing. It is some kind of clothing. All right.
Here's Bert Richardson.
Bert, what do you bid on this item?
$8.
$8 it is. And, Artie, you can give me another question now.
It's not a sweatshirt of some kind.
No, it's not a sweatshirt. No.
Janet,
one last bid. Janet, what do you bid?
$8.50.
No, in dollars.
Dollars?
Even dollars.
How much?
Nine.
$9. $9 it is. One last question, Artie.
I don't know what.
Well, I'll show you what it is. It is your nightshirt.
And you know, Artie. For me.
He's even smaller than I thought. Isn't he?
Oh, wait, this is a very special kind of nightshirt.
Don't tell me about it. Don't tell me about it.
I've got a great deal of...
I do want to know, how much did you pay for it, Artie?
Huh?
$10. How much did you pay
how
for
much,
it?
I paid 33 marks for it.
Well, how much is that in dollars?
33 marks would be about $9.50.
$9.50, so...
Well, then Janet, at $9, is the winner.
Something.
Janet, it's yours, and you can have it. Our next item up for bids.
Oh!
And here we are.
There should have been a specific
area. Well, you get the idea. That's correct. All right. In dollars, Janet, what's your bid?
$25.
Now, this is an item of clothing of yours, Anita, and you bid $25.
You gotta laugh like that?
And you may ask me a question about it.
Well, is it something I wear?
Yes, it's something that you wear. All right,
that's
Bert.
A question?
$17.
$17? Another
it,
question?
I don't have any flimsy things, I don't think.
You don't now.
Special occasions, I do. No, is it, do I wear it at night? Like, do I wear it at night?
Well, you might wear it at night, yeah. It would depend on where you were going. Together? What's your bid?
Marlene.
$15.
How much?
$15.
And another question.
Is it long?
No, of all the things it is not long. No.
$18
and one last question.
$18? I don't have anything worth $18. Is it, well, I do, but, are they briefs of some sort, panties?
It's one of the briefest I've ever seen, as a matter of fact. It is not
what
pink
is it?
Panties. It is a purple bikini.
Oh!
There you are.
And, I remember that old schmuck.
How much did you pay for your purple bikini?
That was $22.
$22?
$22, Steve, who's our winner? That means the other one having gone over. Ellen at 18 is our winner.
Ellen, you'll be beautiful winner. All right, the next item up for bids here is right here.
These are exciting items.
And this is it. Right there. And Dick, this is something of yours, Dick Dawson. And
I just remembered where I left my umbrella.
It's a receptacle, I'll tell you that much.
I'm sorry.
It's something of yours, and it's a receptacle. It's a receptacle. All right, Ellen.
I'll say $15.
$15, she says. Ask me a question about it, Richard.
Would it be my bread bin, where we put the bread?
No, it wouldn't be your bread bin. No, it would not. Marlene?
$12.
$12?
My cufflink box.
No, not your cufflink box. Bert.
$24.
$24.
Do I hear 25?
You may. We have one more bid.
Would it be, jack boots that I have? Big boots.
No, not boots. Janet.
I really put my foot in that one.
How much?
16.
16 it is, Steve, for Janet. And one last question, Richard.
Would it be the goldfish bowl that we have?
Well,
with
I don't.
A whale in it.
I don't think so, unless you keep your fish in the mailbox. It's your mailbox. Now, how much did you pay for the mailbox?
It has the letters and the thing on the...
They were filled with bills when we picked it up. We'll get those back.
I wonder why my mail was down a pole today.
$15. $15 you paid
right
for.
On the head.
And Ellen, you are the winner.
All right, one last item up for bid.
And the last item up for bid is this. And here it is. You can see it. And... this is yours, of course, Pat Carroll, and this is no reflection on you, but please give me your bids in pennies for this.
What? In pennies?
Yes, Janet.
39 cents.
39 cents, she says. Now, this is something that you carry.
I'll raise that.
You. This is something you carry with you.
I carry with me something, a purse.
No, not a purse. Bert, what do you bid for?
43 cents.
43 cents.
An old whiskey bottle.
We put that first, but we dropped it and broke it, so they had to make a substitute. Marlene.
49 cents.
49 cents. Another
would
question.
Would it be a coin purse?
Nope, not a coin purse. What do you say,
50.
Ellen? How much?
50 cents.
50 cents. 50 cents. One last question.
Well, I carry tools in my purse sometimes. Could it be a measuring tool?
No, this is not a tool. It may sound like one at times. It's your kazoo. Your kazoo. And how much did you? How much did you spend for your kazoo?
I think they go. That was one of the cheaper ones. They go for about 39 cents.
39 cents?
Janet is our winner.
Janet is the winner?
Yeah.
And Janet is yours.
Thank you, Bob. Bob, I'll be there with one of them. Thank you.
I've got a secret returns right after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of Bob Barker's birthday
and the... Hey, goodbye, and we'll see you next week with another I've Got a Secret. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Bob Barker. Thank you, panel. Thank you, guests.
I've Got a Secret contestants receive cash awards plus these gifts. For our first contestant, crafted leather watch bands by Topps. Enjoy making your watch new again with these luxurious bands. Topps watch bands available at variety and discount stores everywhere. For our second contestant, a Jean de Tay assortment, including Friction Pour Le Bain, a delicious splash that gives you a fragrant lift after a bath or any time, tingles with the touch of Jean de Tay. For our celebrity guest, Domani, the sensational new cologne and aftershave, softly sensual, boldly bracing Domani, the fragrance of today for the man of tomorrow. Speaking for I've Got a Secret, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totten production. Recorded.